Hi, this is Steve Czarnecki and Liz Shivener.
That's right.
Who is their husband and wife, and the reason we had them come up is they're in Les Mis, and they're from, well, Steve is from Rochester Hills, and Liz married into Rochester Hills.
Yes. So
guilty by association.
Yes, and you're touring. So, first of all, nice to have you guys here.
Thank you so much.
And if you go see Les Mis at the Fisher, you will recognize Steve. He plays a lot of different roles, including the guy who takes Fontaine and hits on her early in the show.
Makes her sing that sad, sad song.
Makes her sing a song and then throws her out and gets her fired.
Yeah.
Do you get run over by something later? You get killed?
Unfortunately, no. He actually, you see him again when she kind of turns and is like a lady of the night, if you will.
Yeah.
And he goes and he hires her.
Oh,
and that's awful.
How do you sleep with yourself? How do you sleep with your wife?
I don't know. She makes me sleep alone, I swear.
Terrible. So you guys have been in this tour for how long?
6 months.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
And when you landed that, when somebody's, because you look quite young, so I imagine you,
you
haven't done that. is that a big deal in an actor's career, or a theater actor's career, to say we got a Les Mis run?
Absolutely. Yes. I mean, we had been working separately for quite some time, 2 years. I was on the Phantom of the Opera tour before this. And so when we booked this job together, let alone just the job by itself is amazing, and then to get to go on the road together is kind of.
Is this the first time you've worked together?
We worked together right out of college, actually. We did a stint on the Beauty and the Beast tour in 2010.
Well, you guys are in
all the big shows.
Yeah.
We only do mega musicals.
Yeah, like I only go to the Super Bowl, sorry. I don't do preseason. Yeah. And did you, Steve, did you train here, in Michigan? Was Michigan responsible for you?
I grew up in Rochester Hills and I went to Adams High School, and so my kind of first foray into musical theater was through the Rochester Community Schools system. They do a summer music theater program directed by Tim Lentz at the time. Mm-hmm. And then eventually I went down to Ohio where I met this one, where I went to college.
Where the good schools are?
You're going to have to leave now.
She's going
to get so much. Oh, no.
What school was that? No,
sorry, everybody.
We went to Otterbein University.
Got to know. Okay. It's nowhere near Columbus, right?
No, it's just
as long as they don't have a football team.
They don't. Well, they do. It's just not very good.
Yeah. What is it called? Otterbein?
Otterbein.
What's the name of the team in Otterbein?
Oddly enough, the Cardinals.
The Cardinals, not
the Otterbein
Cardinals.
I would have guessed that. By the way, even though Les Mis is, usually when Les Mis comes to town, people say, I can't get tickets, it's sold out. We're informed that every day tickets are released. And so if you check every day, you may be able to get seats, maybe able to get some decent seats or even good seats for it, even though it's, a lot of the tickets are gone already. Steve, what would be your recommendation? And Liz, even though you didn't grow up here and you mentioned Ohio, to young people who are listening who, have a feeling like, well, how can I ever get to do Broadway musicals when I live in Michigan?
Yeah, I mean, it's going to take practice. It's going to take a lot of hard work. One thing I wish I had done when I was younger was I wish I took dance class. I thought I was going to be like this big sports guy growing up, and then not looking back, I'm like, man, Mom, I wish you would have put me in ballet because I could really use that now.
Yeah, you never would have made it out of high school.
It wasn't worth it, though.
Yeah, yeah.
I think a big part of it is just also surrounding yourself people who are training you, but a good group of friends. We were fortunate to have a graduating class that all moved to New York City together.
Mm-hmm.
And so we weren't just, a 21-year-old from Michigan
but
or a 21-year-old.
You still have to do that. I mean, you pretty much have to go to New York
if you
want to be in professional theater.
There's definitely certain cities that kind of operate a little bit on their own. Chicago and Seattle a little bit operate on their own with, they've got a whole pool of working local actors.
And more theaters every year in those cities.
Yeah, but New York is still the place to go.
And not L.A. L.A.
Not
for movies.
Theater. Yeah, for the movies. Yeah. Exactly.
So did you guys, move into some way Upper West Side.
Upper West Side would be a bit of a stretch.
Yeah, 190 something. Not really, not the Upper West Side.
We used to
live Bronx.
Just before the Bronx, basically, is where we were.
Yeah. And have you worked your way down with your successes?
Well, we've worked our way into a storage unit so we could be on the Les Mis.
Oh, okay.
Exactly.
And oddly enough, it's in the Bronx.
Yeah.
See, there you go. Well, so you're back in the Bronx again.
Precisely.
Well, and when you get to now in Detroit, you're actually, what I love about this is Steve says, we finish the show and then we drive
drive back to Rogers Hills because they're staying with his parents, which is great. So, like, it must be weird. You're going to be on stage tonight.
Yeah.
There's going to be all these people cheering for you guys. You come out, you take the big bow at the beautiful Fisher Theater, and then you go home to the bed you slept in when you were in junior high.
Luckily, it's his childhood bedroom.
Yeah, it's my childhood bedroom. However, my parents, there's, like, no sign of the children that once were there.
Okay.
They've redone the entire place.
Room.
Still, though, you got to get up in the morning, get the cornflakes out.
Oh yeah.
That's one of the benefits about being on tour is actually finding cities where you have friends and family that
you only
see at the holidays.
Prefer to stay with them if you can, just to break up the monotony of the hotel.
Absolutely. It's just nice to just get that kind of home feeling while you're there.
Well, especially you're on the road for 6 months, and you said you're going to do another 6 months.
Yes, sir.
Wow, a year.
Yeah, a year.
And Liz plays lots of different roles. You're what they call a swing, right? So that means you can.
Yeah, so I know 8 tracks. I know all 8 of the female ensemble tracks. And then sometimes when things get crazy, I step into male tracks just to make the machine stay running. I'm a new Fontaine cover, which is exciting. And I'm also the dance captain. So I'm responsible with the resident director for keeping things sharp and making sure that every city along
the
way.
And Steve
is
the fight captain.
Yes, and so
between
just
the
like,
two of you, you know, you're the dancing or fighting.
Exactly.
Wow. A lot of furniture broken in your apartment, I imagine. Well, congratulations on this. Nice to have you back home.
Thank you.
We're proud of anyone who makes it from here and does this on a Broadway level. And I don't need to tell people that they should go see Les Miserables. It's an incredible show. But I do need to tell you that you can get tickets. Check every day, right?
Mm-hmm. Like, 2 hours before the box office.
2 hours before the box office.
The updated number of tickets.
Yeah, so check every day. It's now between now and March 11th at the Fisher Theater. Tuesday through Saturday evening performances at 8. Sunday evening at 7:30. Saturday and Sunday matinees at 2. Steve and Liz, so nice to have you
here. Thank you for
having
us.
Thank you.